this particular day, as George made his way to the Carpenter's Arms for his daily pint, there was nothing to indicate that in a very short time the peace of our village would be rudely shattered. In common with the other villagers, George had been using this old right-of-way as a shortcut for many years, as, in George's own words, it enabled him to have his pint 10 minutes earlier than by taking the normal route. Addition to the village and was commonly referred to as that foreigner from Sussex, didn't approve of the footpath which ran over his land. Doctor's son had wasted no time in getting to know the Colonel's daughter, and George, always looking for an excuse to celebrate, was watching the affair with interest. Thank you. It was at this point, having informed the village, that George came to see me. I was naturally shocked, and having always been an advocate of the theory there is safety in numbers, I decided to enlist the assistance of the squire and doctor before calling on the colonel. Colonel's answer was an emphatic no, and keep away from my daughter was added for John's benefit. That evening, George had assembled his drinking pals in the Carpenter's Arms and was busy planning his campaign for dismantling the fence. He didn't know until later that the colonel's gamekeeper also liked an occasional drink. Person about, but there were more important things than milk on his mind. Commando tactics were on the agenda at the old barn, where George had gathered his assault party for last-minute briefing and issuing of weapons. Thank you. starting from what he considered a personal defeat the previous day, George rose early, bent on seeking revenge. He knew that the Colonel always took an early morning walk, and planned accordingly. Just broken the world record for the 100-yard sprint, the fence remained standing. George, being temporarily out of ideas, was found by John in his second home, where he suggested the Colonel's resistance might be weakened by slipping reducing rusks into the food of the Colonel's prize pig. Thank you. screen had diminished away, the fence remained as large and solid as on the day it was erected. John, therefore, decided to do some investigating. To everyone's intense disappointment, it appeared that the blocked footpath was not really a right-of-way at all. Persistent with maps as he was with the colonel's daughter. Another map revealed an ancient and long forgotten right-of-way, one which ran across the land on which the colonel's house had been built. We knew now that we had the colonel where we wanted him, and it only remained to put our plan into operation. village was back to normal. Bulls were undisturbed. Pigs were allowed to grow fatter. John and Myra were engaged. And George was able to return to serious drinking. Indeed, apart from the brand new signpost, it was difficult to believe it had ever happened.